The Devil and Sherlock Holmes is a collection of true stories. All of them involve some element of intrigue and mystery, and people who are fairly obsessive in trying to unravel those mysteries. One of the stories deals with a social injustice in Texas, one of the clearest cases in US history of an innocent man who was executed based on junk science. Another story involves a Polish novelist who allegedly planted clues in his postmodern novel to an actual murder. And the detective who has to try to crack that case is someone who has never been exposed to postmodernism and has to try to decode this novel. Another story deals with the search for a giant squid, in which I ended up going out with a squid hunter in a typhoon off the coast of New Zealand in a little skiff, trying to search for a giant squid, which at that time had never been seen or captured alive. All these stories are true, and they all deal with some element of mystery. One of the central stories in the book, which part of the title is taken from, is about the world's greatest Sherlock Holmes scholar, who was found mysteriously garroted in his apartment. And the case was taken up by all these Sherlockians, his friends who were Sherlockians, and they try to solve this case, which they consider a greater case than any that Sherlock Holmes had ever solved in his fiction. I tried to find overlapping themes. They all dealt with people exploring the human condition, and so some of them just fit a little bit more into intrigue, mysterious circumstances. Some were slightly darker crimes. One of the stories that's in that collection I came to France to tell, which is called The Chameleon, which is about a French imposter, one of the greatest imposters ever, who used to, he didn't just assume the character the way many imposters did. His characters were always young people. He always kind of wanted to stay young. He was like the Peter Pan of imposters. And he eventually pretended to be a missing child from Texas in the United States. And he went to Texas and was brought in by this family. But one of these things that all these stories try to do is when you think you kind of know where something is happening, the ground suddenly begins to fall in. There's an instability to them and to the truth. And so this is a case where the imposter, who has pretended to be this missing child, begins to think that he may be the one being conned and that the family really knows, allegedly knows, what had happened to the missing child. So he suddenly becomes the investigator himself. Each story stays with you in different ways, and each story is very different. I think one of the most important stories in the collection is the story about this man, Cameron Todd Willingham, who woke up one day in his house. His house was on fire. He came outside the house. His children ended up being killed in this fire, and fire investigators came into the house and later claimed that evidence indicated that he had set the fire. And he was accused of triple homicide, and he was put on death row, and he was ultimately executed. And up to the day he died, he insisted he was an innocent man of this crime. And new scientific evidence has shown that the evidence used in that case was essentially witchcraft, that the quote-unquote arson evidence used to suggest he had lit the fire was junk, it was myths, none of it was based on in reality. And the case slowly collapses. And so the fact that the United States executed an innocent man for a crime he did not commit has a moral import. So that story stays with you. In some ways, is the most haunting. But they each have a certain element. I think The Chameleon, about this French imposter who suddenly wonders whether he is the one being conned, has kind of reversals and unexpected twists that, again, I often use the quote from Sherlock Holmes that truth is stranger than fiction, and that is one of those stories like that. In terms of an experience reporting a story, Probably the most crazy I've ever had was searching for that giant squid on a skiff in the middle of a typhoon with my captain, who insisted we go out searching in this little boat in this hurricane because that was the only time he'd have a chance to capture this baby giant squid. And apparently you could only catch a baby giant squid at night, so we had to go out at night in this little boat. And at one point we're heading toward, and I see something in front of me, and it's enormous wall, it looks like, and I had a flashlight with me, and I poke it in front of me, and there in front of me is about a 20-foot wall of water. And then I turn behind me, and right behind me is about a 20-foot wall of water. And our little boat is going like this in this giant skiff. And the captain at one point turned to me and he said, "You won't find this made in New York, will you?" And at that point, I began to wonder whether my captain was fully in command of all his faculties.